So I recorded the video I made yesterday, and I thought about it, like, you know what? That video, I mean, so far I've made videos about preventing yourself from goofing up, but there are a lot of dudes, this is what the majority of guys are going through right now. Majority of guys are going through a situation where they already, like, the relationship is already kind of in, not in shambles, but they're past the point where they need to flip the chessboard, but they don't know. They didn't even realize it was too late until I started bringing up the points that I started bringing up. Like, bro, every time I've talked to any of the homies or, you know, either even girls that, you know, they were just in a relationship, it's already too late. And I'm telling them in retrospect, because I mean, shit, that's how I learned. I learned when it was already too late. I had to look at it in retrospect and be like, okay, this is what I should have done. This is what I needed to do, blah, blah, blah. But see, the key, the only way to really apply those things is to know when it's time to apply those things. So this video is about how to know when you slip too far. What does it mean? You know what I mean? You're like, well, dude, how do I know if I'm already at the point where I need to flip the chessboard? Like, what are the, you know, what, basically, what am I looking for to know that? So look, at the beginning of every relationship, especially if you're in a relationship with a woman that's beautiful, that has, you know, ego. Women do have self-esteem issues, but it's really just, it's more of just like a, they're not sure if what they think is the right move. So that's where you get all that second guessing, that testing comes from, because they're not even sure in you all the way, which is the reason why she's testing you all the time in the first place. So a lot of times you have a girl who she's used to just kind of doing whatever she wants to do in a relationship. So she tries to test you in small microaggressive ways. Like, she does microaggressions. Like, bro, I know girls that, you know, they play fight. They try to play fight with you. You know, the gym shorties, man, they love testing your ass. Not gonna lie, they do like, you know, they like gym guys. It's not a requirement, but like, bro, if your girl is stronger than you and she's testing you and you're folding, bro, like, last girl I was with, or it was last girl. A little last couple girls, but I learned this a long time ago where, look, girls try to play fight with you and stuff like that. It's important that you check that shit at the door and let her know, like, look, man, you're not stronger than me. You can't play fight with me. I'm not going to play fight with you, because if I, you know, at the minute I do, you know, your feelings are going to get hurt. You're going to be, why did you hit me so hard? And it's inevitable, dog. It's inevitable. That's a fight that, you know what I mean? She trying to grab on you and blah, blah, blah. All you got to do, you know what I mean? Like, my old girl, she tried to hit me in the chest. I grabbed her wrist like, dog, this is, you know, I'm stronger than you. Don't be trying to put hands on me. Don't be trying to put hands on other dudes. It's not cool. It's kind of like when your dog tries to lay on you, right? And if you allow your dog to lay on you and stand over you while you're laying down or whatever, it's testing to see if, you know, it can be dominant over you. And if it can, it'll abuse it, because women become abusive when you fail these tests. It's in their nature. Once again, I don't blame them. It's our fault if we let it happen. It's just that simple. You know what I mean? Stop asking. Oh, but we'll get there. Another microaggression, right? She'd be trying to talk shit and roast with you, right? There's a lot of dudes that are afraid to roast their girl back. Afraid to, like, cook them like they would normally cook a nigga on the block. Bro, cook her ass every time, all right? Just, she want to roast? Okay, cool, roast her. Talk, but I'm not going to lie. I always am talking shit all the time. Like, it's a little friendly shit, but girls, you know, they fuck with it because, you know, you got a slick mouth and pause. You got a slick mouth and you're witty. These are good signs. That's the underlying thing that they're noticing, is like that they're getting attracted to is, oh, he's witty, you know, he's quick-witted, he's funny, because you know, keep it lighthearted, man. Don't be out here wilding, but you know, you make fun of I don't know, she trying a little extra hard today, point it out, make fun of her a little bit, just be like, you know, whatever, right? Just make it so that way she's engaging with you on that level. But if your girl is flaming you for being bummy and this and that, see, that's how you know whether or not, like, if you ain't got no comebacks for your girl dropping bummy jokes on you and stuff like that, bro, you're just not qual. Like, there's nothing you can really do, because there's nothing you can really say besides getting your feelings. There's nothing logical she could. It's a checkmate, bro. So, like, I know that people be like, bro, you got to qualify for this type of girl, blah, blah, blah. That whole thing is figured out pretty fast, like, whether or not you can hang, essentially, right? Because the point is, you need to be better than the girl that you're with. She needs to feel as though you're better than her. You're a winner. You know what I mean? So here is when you know you let it go too far, is when she starts to get to the point to where I talked about yesterday, right? where she starts hitting you with that pullback cheese, that's because, you know, the step back, she hit you with the step back jumper because you didn't check everything. Or matter of fact, you know what I mean? You did what I did, which is I checked some things, but I didn't even realize what I had let slide in the beginning because I was just so worried about how much I liked the bitch, man. She slid on by with a couple of things. Next thing you know, I'm like, wait, what the oh, damn. That's literally how it hit me. Like, damn, I fucked up. That was literally how it hit me. Like, you know what I mean? We gotta go back to the drawing board because this right here fucked it up, man. I fucked it up. So the key is you gotta be not ruthless, but you have to be diligent, bro. Every time she try to hit you with something that just makes you feel it's a gut feeling. Yeah, nah, you should definitely be checking that and being like, you know, blah, blah, blah. Don't get in your feelings and be like, what do you mean by that? Never. You got to have something valid, like righteous to come back with. If she say, oh, your shoes, blah, 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 blah. I'd be like, man, like if a bitch rolls my shoes and she got some dirty Air Forces on, you know what I mean? You can make fun of that. You know what I mean? But like in a way that it's like, damn, you know what I mean? Like, bro, everybody knows the girls that be wearing the dirty Air Forces give the best top. You know what I mean? Joke about it like that. Like, I'm not gonna lie, it does sound crazy, but that shit'll get you in the door in a way that you'll be like, damn. You know what I mean? Like, you'll be like, man, shut up, cause you got them. Like, shut up, you got them dick suckers on. Like, what are you talking about? It's like, bro, everybody knows the bitches that wear dirty Air Forces go to all the festivals and give the best top. You know what I mean? And you just like make, like, you just type shit. You get what I'm saying? Keep the innuendo alive. Keep the vibes alive. Make sure that it's lighthearted for her to laugh it off or whatever. You know what I mean? But, yeah. And when you get to the point to where you feel as though you're losing her, it's not all the way gone. Like, another microaggression to where, you know, okay, it's getting a little bit serious is when she just tries to be a contrarian to you, right? Which is like, she's like the, oh, I'm too cool for niggas type bitch, where she just is a contrarian, right? Like, you might say you like something, and then she just like criticizing like everything that you like. You know what I mean? That type of shit. Look, man. Would you have in that situation? Because that situation is one of those things where a lot of women they just won't agree with you because they don't want to agree with you. Like, not because they don't want to, but just to be a contrarian, bro. Just kind of be a dick. Like, bro, I know girls, right? I've dealt with women where they'll never admit they liked you because they just had an ego and they wouldn't tell you, but they do everything that shows you that they like you. So look, if they're showing you that they're like you, but they're talking a little shit, look, man, don't harp so much on the semantics. That's what girls do, where they be like, why aren't you telling me, blah, blah, blah. They get all caught up on what's being said instead of what's being done. Don't be blind to the signs of what's being done. Because if you fall for that, where she starts being a contrarian, saying everything that you say is wrong for no reason, you either ask her why and let her fumble over her explanation because she doesn't have one. Because it's just kind of, it's a feeling. You know what I mean? It's not a genuine issue. It's a feeling. So, see, because it's a feeling and not a point of view, there's no way she'll be able to explain it. Trust me. Trust me. It'll be like this. Oh, I don't know. I feel like, you know, I'm not sure about this. And then you're like, why? I don't know. Like, I just been thinking. Whoa. I mean, what have you been thinking? I don't know. It's just like that. I don't know. You're like, well, goddamn, bitch, what do you know? But ignore it when it comes to things like that where she's feeling away. Bro, shut up and ignore it. Don't go and harp on the feeling, because that's what they do every day, bro. They're going to feel a different way. She's going to hate you on Tuesday. She's going to love you on Wednesday. She's going to be a horny ass bitch on Thursday. She's going to be have an attitude on Friday. And what you do is the same thing you always do. That's the key, right? So if you're in a situation where, right, see my boy, I'll use him as an example. His girl hit him with the step back jumper. I don't know about this relationship jumper. And I told him, I said, look, man, because they were supposed to go to the gym that day. I said, look, man, when you pull up on her, work out. Don't even talk about, because if she created the problem, don't make it your problem. If a girl creates problems in her own mind, every girl does, right? Especially when she's texting you versus when she sees you. if she acts a certain way over text messages, text her less. Ignore the feeling paragraph and all that type of shit, because she'll regret that she even sent that shit later on where you don't even pay it any mind. And look, if she runs off, then she runs off. But if you don't want to entertain, you don't want to give her more emotion to feed on, because you're setting yourself up to lose your girl and have to flip the chessboard. Don't engage with the emotions, bro. If she's sending you something like that, where I don't know about this relationship, I don't know, you know what I mean? First of all, you didn't check some earlier on, because now she's feeling unsure. But at the same time, you know what I mean? Because that ego, you know, that once again, that step back jumper is the ego move. She's trying to get that control again in the relationship. And right, that is the brink. That ghosting shit, all my boys, and I see a lot of guys complain about getting ghosted. Right, you're being ghosted because when she gives you that feeling of you're too available, bro. You're not elusive enough. You're not focusing on your purpose. She's noticing you're taking time away from your purpose to focus on her, and innately it grosses her out when you're all in love with the bitch. Like, she just doesn't like that. So girls are only going to stay with you for as long as it took for them to pussy you up. So if it took her about a week and she got you in your feelings, you got about another week, and then she's going to be over it. She's not going to enjoy it. You know what I mean? If it took you 5 years, it's going to take, she's going to enjoy that pussy shit for about 5 more years because of all the shit you put her through being hard body. If you understand what I'm saying? If you're not diligent all the time, the minute you slip up, it's a ticking time bomb until you got to blow up the relationship till you have to. And me, luckily for me, I have been through this situation before. I've been ghosted before. Shit, there's people that are in the comment section of my videos that played this game with me personally. You know what I mean? Where they wasted some of my time and shit. And I should have blown it up a long time ago. But I just felt like I didn't want to let her go, because I was just like, man, this girl, I like her, blah, blah, blah. But this is for, you know, when you're just getting into a relationship, how to not let her self-sabotage and how to not fuck it up by feeding into her emotions and making her run away from you. Because that's exactly what will happen. Trust me. Every time if you feed into her emotions. Now, if you stay doing what it is you always do, she brings up something to you that's emotional, and you just ask her why, you know, why? Oh, well, I don't know why, you know. And it's just like, okay, so you don't know why. Okay, so what are you just feeling like this today? You know what I mean? You just feel away today, whatever. I'm not worried about that. And then it's just back to business. And if she see it, and if it's really something that needs to be talked about, sometimes, you know what I mean? I've been hit with that we need to talk thing where they'll tell you something that they noticed that they didn't like. And I've been there. You know what I mean? That's cool. But if it's just like a feeling, you know, just ignore it, bro. Keep doing what you've been doing. I always go off on tangents, fuck. But my friend, him and his girl are supposed to see each other. I told him, go to the gym, work out. She's gonna say, oh, well, I can't. I said, look, when you see her, say, hey, all right, and then start working out together. Keep it strictly business, because she caused the problem that pissed you off. So make her feel the consequences of her actions. Hold her accountable, not by telling her to be held accountable, but hold her accountable with your actions by just being a little more distant, man. Right now, she knows there's something wrong, but she has a choice to make. She can either submit her ego, be humble, come to you and say, look, no, we got a problem. I want to talk about it. I'm sorry. You know what I mean? I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have caused that. Then you can say, okay, what's up? We could talk. But if she doesn't even bring it up and she knows that you're pissed off, she doesn't care about what you think, doesn't care about how you feel, right? A lot of time girls will be like, I can't get no hug. Why are you just going to act like that? And you just like, I'm working out. Right now, if she just doesn't care, she doesn't ever bring it up, then yeah, you know, then you kind of see where she's at. If she does bring it up, then y'all could deal with it. That's essentially what I'm saying. Do what you always do. She's going to make problems. She's going to test you. And don't engage in her feelings with your feelings. When she says something to you, don't snap because she says something to you. Whatever anger you do have and resentment and frustration you do have, it has to be righteous. And it has to be not taken out on her, but it has to be you venting your frustration in a way that you still leave her with something to think about. Okay, be careful in how you spaz. There's a way to do it. There's a way to shake in the tree that could get some shit done that you want done versus just being a fucking dick, right? Kind of have to be a little bit of both, but you have to drop something in there for her to think about, for her to take away. Because like I said, she may block you, she may disappear for a minute, but she'll remember the last thing you told her before she comes back. And then if it proves to be true, then you know, in no time she'll be back and be like blah blah blah. And then depending on the consequences she ran out while she was gone, you can decide, you know, hey bitch, where you been, blah blah blah, then y'all can talk it out. Or if she, look, she come back with a baby or something, because that happened to me before. Bitch disappeared on me, came back with a fucking baby, nigga. And I was like, look, I'll hit and give you some game here and there, but you can't be my girl though. It's over with. You it's over with. Essentially, right? So that's what I want to kind of go a little more in depth about what it is to, that you're supposed to, that the signs that put you in the shit in the first place, the microaggressions, the things that, you know, girls say, because we've all been there, dude. We've all been there. And women, I'm telling you, you're not special when it comes to what y'all do, how y'all feel. Bro, we have countless, well, not all of us, but if you're dealing with women, you got countless stories of how she ghosted you, what she said before, and it was always the same thing, all right? Now, when guys be telling the same lies and capping, the only time dudes do things that are the same is when they're in their feelings and when they're lying and all that weird shit. That's when you get those typical guys where you're like, I heard this before. If you get you a dude that you ain't ever heard nobody come at you like this before, fuck with him. That's what you want. I'm out, man.